heel strike running may be unsustainable from an injury prevention standpoint is that it may increase the risk of hamstring tightness, pain, and injury. This is because running with the heel strike may cause higher rates of tension and compression on the hamstrings as compared with forefoot strike running. The extent to which heel strike running may be considered a risk factor for hamstring pain and injury is that in many cases, landing heel first when running is often accompanied by maximum knee extension at touchdown, which means the knee is fully unbent at heel strike. This produces and overstride where initial foot strike position or the extended leg is positioned farther ahead of the mass of the body. In this condition, the mass of the body collides more intensively with the extended leg, and also the mass of the body is colliding with the extended leg for a longer period of time as compared with forefoot strike running. The prolonged collision force that occurs between the mass of the body and the extended leg in heel strike running produces a compressive wave that actually ripples up the leg through the hips. Not to mention, this collisional force and therefore compressive wave increases in proportion to your speed and your body weight when running with an overstride coupled with landing heel first. So the faster you run and or the more that you weigh when you run with an overstride as well as a heel strike landing, these forces increase in intensity and duration. For one, the problem with having a fully extended leg and therefore maximum knee extension or a fully unbent knee at touchdown during running is that it stretches the hamstrings to the point where the hamstrings exceed beyond maximum tension during the phase of running, that is the touchdown phase, where the collisional force and the compressive wave are very high. Multiple lines of research, which are linked down below this video in the description box, speculate that this specific landing configuration under these high impact conditions during running may easily give rise to a hamstring injury because of the increased amount of time the hamstrings spend in a maximally stretched state to produce the overstride mechanics at touchdown in heel strike running. And because of the increased amount of time the hamstrings spend enduring the collisional force and compressive wave, on account of the collisional force is greater in intensity and longer in duration in heel strike running than in forefoot strike running, microscopic muscle damage to the hamstrings may arise and hamstring injury can manifest in this one way. In contrast, the hamstrings may be less vulnerable to pain and injury in forefoot strike running because landing forefoot first during running contributes to a shorter stride length where the chances of overstriding is much lower than in heel strike running. This is because when you make the conscious effort of landing on the balls of the foot, knee extension at touchdown is naturally reduced, which means the knee joint has a tendency to bend and flex more at touchdown in forefoot running. So there's a much less extended leg at touchdown, which in turn means the foot lands closer to the mass of the body. And this accounts for big reductions in collisional intensity as well as the duration of the collisional force. This not only results in far less compressive loads transmitted to the hamstrings, but since the knee is more bent at touchdown, the hamstrings are now required to stretch less at touchdown, and thus the hamstrings are less likely to stretch to reach the micro tear inducing stretch force threshold in forefoot running. So these are good reasons why forefoot strike running may bring more help in reducing the risk of hamstring pain and injury as compared with heel strike running, because for one, there's less knee extension at touchdown, which directly reduces stretch force and tension on the hamstrings. And secondly, all around impact levels are often much less brute and intensive in forefoot strike running, which is even better for the hamstrings. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't already, where you'll stay more informed on forefoot strike running versus heel strike running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.